I'm Susan Ratai Lane with the MIT App Inventor Development Team, and this is an overview of features in our August 2021 release, nb187. This is a fairly large release, and I'm only covering four of the largest additions here. I encourage you to take a look at the release notes, which should be included in the text notes that accompany this video. First, let's look at our new visual accessibility features. These features enable the development of apps that are more accessible to users with visual impairment. You will find these on screen one with the rest of the properties that apply to the entire application. First, we can take a look at big default text. It does what you might expect. Here you can see that text that is set to the default size, which is 14 points. And you can see here we have 14 points for label 2, which is current color. Whenever the font is set to 14, the property big default text will make it larger to increase visibility. Also along these lines, you will see high contrast right here. Again, you can see that whenever default colored text is found against default colored background, the colors are adjusted to make them easier to read. A third accessibility option we have added is the alternate text property. This is for images, and you can see it's very much as you might think. It's a new property that allows text to be added as they are in HTML applications. This allows the app to be read by screen readers with information around what those images are. Next, let's take a look at the new preview options that come with this release. Now, previously, we have had a phone size previews to allow for the design of applications targeting different screen size. This is phone size. You can see tablet size and monitor size. Now, this already exists before the new release. You can see that it only appears when the sizing on screen one is set to responsive. See, it's gone when we set to fixed. The new preview features are for device types. We have the old Android, which is the Holo theme. We have new Android, which is the Material theme. And we have iOS 13 devices. This just gives you a better idea of what your layout should look like on these different devices so that you can design to either look good on all of them or to look appropriate on whichever devices you're targeting. These new preview options only appear if the theme set on screen one is device default. If you set to classic, you'll notice that they go away. And default, and they're back again. Our third feature here, we'd like to show you the list view, which has been overhauled to include layouts for list items. Here, I will create a new project to give you an idea of what that looks like. Here we have a new list view. The old way that list views were handled would allow you to put single strings separated by commas to pre-populate with elements. And here you see, and a single element can be selected at a time. Now we have introduced layouts and more sophisticated data elements to our old list view. So here you can look down and see that we have list view layout as a property. This allows you to select 1, 2, and 3 element list item layout. So here we'll take a look at main text and detail text vertical. Now data will be entered in the list data editor. So you click here, you can add a row, and you can see it asks for main text and detail text. And here you have one element, And you can see that it has two strings, now called one and one detail text, and those strings can have separate properties. Yeah, so here we have font typeface, font detail typeface. Here I shall set the font typeface to serif and the font detail to monospace. They can have different sizes. They can have different colors. And here we have a very, very colorful element. And we add more elements with the list data entry editor. So here I'll add a few more. I'm not being terribly creative here with my strings, but I think you can follow. And now we have three elements. We can now reselect one, and we can also configure the selection color. Okay, so those are the two string layouts. Main text, detail text, vertical or horizontal. Then we have elements that include images. Here we have main text and image. Images are uploaded using our media upload interface as any image used elsewhere in the application would be. If we select an image in main text layout, and go to add delete data, you can see that we now have the option to add an image, and we can add different images or the same one. And here we see our images. The image is also configurable. So we have here the image height property and image width. But this can be however large you like within reason. This also accompanies the image main text and detail text. And this now allows us to use all three elements. Here we have the orientation, which can be vertical, which is what you're used to seeing, a vertical list of elements. And now we also have a horizontal view. This allows you to page through elements, much like you might page through a card listing. This makes more sense for large images. So perhaps they'll make our image even larger. This could easily be, say, an album cover. And again, you have the same form of selection. Final feature is pretty simple to look at, but has a lot of possibilities. App Inventor now has the option to build app bundles. Android app bundles are a Google publishing format that include all your apps, compiled code, and resources. It allows you to upload that to Google Play and allow Google Play to produce optimized APKs for each device configuration. Our new feature is to be able to export these as well as the traditional APKs. You'll find the feature under Build. And now you'll see that we have only one option for building APKs as well as a new one for AAB or Android App Bundle. Both of these behave the same way. They allow you to build your app. And when your app is complete, you can download an AAB to your hard drive. And if you build an APK, and when your build is complete, you'll see that you still have both options for downloading your finished APK, both the QR code and the hard drive download link, but they're now presented on a single screen. That's the conclusion of these highlights of our summer 2021 release. I encourage you to take a look at our full release notes as they exist on the web. Thank you very much.